Without that grassroots, we don't have any champions. Don't have any David Beckhams or David Hayes, or you know, you need coaches to really keep the kids on a straight and narrow. You know, particularly with today's society where everybody's focused on sitting around pressing buttons. It's such a for sport. Me, you know, I know as a hyperactive kid, sitting down playing a computer game isn't going to give me the focus and drive that I'd need to live a focused, fulfilled life. I need to do sport. And this really does make a difference, having a coach who, you know, really gives you disciplines, gives you drive, gives you focus. It makes a huge difference. And some of these guys, these unsung heroes, some of these guys who've worked for years and years and never really got any recognition or credibility, it's fantastic. Just to be nominated for something like this will really put a smile on their face. Because they're not doing it for the accolades, they're not doing it for the credibility. If they was, they wouldn't be doing it. They'd be doing something else. But it's nice for us to pick a few of these guys out and really, you know, give them a pat on the back and say, you know, keep doing what you're doing, because you're really making a difference in many people's lives.
Of course, you're back to doing what you do best. What gave you the drive? What was the main motivation for doing that?
It's just I was fortunate to have a mother and father who were very, very open-minded, and they really supported me at every stage. You know, when I was a very young child, I said I want to be the heavyweight champion of the world, and they said, well, you can be anything you want to be. You know, as long as you train hard, as long as you focus, you know, as long as you're the best at it, just crack on. You know, and that, having that, you know, dad driving you to the gym every day, you know, it doesn't sound like much, but there's a lot of parents out there who are too lazy to rather, you know, put a computer game in the kid's hand instead of taking him to the park to play football or taking him to the swimming baths. Or, you know, it's really nice for coaches to take time out of their busy days to train some of these kids, you know, or even train adults, just to really get everybody together. You get that real nice camaraderie, and it's something that really lasts with you forever.
You're working with a fantastic coach with Sean. Can you talk a little bit about just what makes him such a unique coach and how you think that's going to give you the edge this time?
I think it helps that he's young. He's just turned 27. You know, for a coach to be 27, I think he's probably one of the youngest coaches I know to have trained a legitimate world champion. He trains Carl Frampton, who's an excellent fighter. You know, arguably the best super bantamweight fighter on the planet. And he's going to prove that against Scott Quigg in February when they go toe-to-toe for the WBA super title and the IBF title. It's going to be fantastic. But he's definitely added some nice combinations, speed, timing. He's really, really sort of just, I feel like Haymaker 2.0 now. You know, I'm fighting on January 16th, you know, O2 Arena. You know, tickets go on sale on Friday. Really got a good response so far. And I'm just happy to be back, you know, giving the fans what they want. You know, I'm fighting a good guy who hasn't lost in 11 years, so it's going to be a good little tear up. You know, they call him the Dominator, Mark Demory. So that's going to be fun, bashing him up in front of all my fans.
Sure, you're going to do that. My final question is very quickly. How important do you think it is for the heavyweight division that whether it's Tyson or hopefully yourself, someone ends the dominance of these Klitschko guys?
I think it's important. You need fresh blood. You need new guys, you know, doing their thing and knocking people out in good spectacular fashion. I'm not sure Tyson Fury is the man to do that, but hopefully I'll get my chance in a not so distant future.
I think it's more than that. It recognises the unsung heroes who don't get a mention, who spend their life living in the shadow and never get a mention, and often spend 30, 40 years of their life where nobody actually knows who they are, and yet they've produced, or they have been in the embryonic stages of developing young people's careers, and kids that can go on and become superstars. It all happens with the help and support that you get at grassroots level. There are two sort of views on Klitschko. He's a tremendous athlete, very intelligent man. Speak five languages, has a PhD in sports science, is a great representative for the sport. And then there are those who say, yeah, that's great, but he's also boring because he tends to be, you know, a grab when you get up close, and he keeps you at long range, and the fights are not that exciting. But, you know, you look at his record and you look back over the years, he lost the title for, I think, about 9 months during the period of the last decade, but he's been heavyweight champion of the world for 10 years. So that's pretty spectacular stuff. So, bottom line, he's been a great champion. Whether you like his style or not is a completely subjective thing. But without a doubt, he has been a tremendous representative for the sport of boxing.
Of course, Tyson couldn't be more of a contrast, a very colourful character. Do you think his antics, particularly the way he was behaving at the initial press conference for the Klitschko fight, do you think they help the sport or detract from
it? I think he is his whole thing is full of contradiction. You don't know whether he's in good form or he's bad form. He's bipolar. He says, he admits some days he feels like just stepping in front of a bus. Other days he feels on top of the world. He's a real contradiction, but he can fight. He is a great character. PR, they say there's no such thing as a bad PR. It was Brendan Meehan who said there's no such thing as bad PR except it's your own obituary. So certainly Tyson Fury must adhere to that belief, because his rants are not the nicest things, but he's certainly good publicity. And he's certainly a character. He's got a chance, there's no doubt about it, but you've got to go with the pedigree, and Klitschko is far and away above him ability-wise. Yeah, David Haye, that is. My son Shane is training him. I don't have anything to do with him other than my son's training him. He comes to the gym a lot and spends a bit of time with us, and that is it's great seeing him back, because I think he always spices up the heavyweight division. Very articulate, very attractive looking guy, tremendous puncher, hugely explosive, there's no doubt about it, he is a valuable contribution to the heavyweight division, which in this country is absolutely flying at the moment. You've got Tyson Fury, you've got Anthony Joshua, you've got David Haye coming back into it as well, and it's any of these guys on any given night can produce great results and could upset any of the heavyweights. When you punch as hard as these guys punch, certainly as far as Haye is concerned, if he hits any of the heavyweights, he'll take them out. And he's thrown more punches than ever before. He feels better than he's ever been before. He's had he's been plagued with injuries. It's 3 years off. He feels a new man. Shane is introducing more volume of punches. His fitness levels are going through the roof. He's in incredible condition, looks great, been sparring great, has been really hurting his sparring partner so far. He's going to step that up and ramp it up for his fight on the 16th of January. So he is really back with a vengeance.
Grassroots is everything, because you all start at grassroots, and I think that's where all the funding should go personally. I think it's so important to encourage, to inspire, and sport does so many things. It can completely change lives. I know that sounds a cliche, but it can inspire so many young people to go on to whether being an elite athlete or work in sports coaching or as a sports presenter like myself. Women's sport's been incredible the last 12 months, and it's finally starting to get the recognition it deserves, which is so important when we talk about grassroots, because it's not only boys that we need to inspire. We need to inspire girls to show that they can go into sport as young girls, as women, as females. I think we have crossed a bit of a watershed, but I think there's a long way to go. Attitudes are starting to change, but it takes time to break down stereotypes and stigmas, and I'm really proud of the women's football team and so many inspiring female athletes out there. I think with football, it's got to start with the top, really. I think it's got to change from above, because there's only Heather Rabatz who's involved in football from a female perspective. I think from the board needs to change, because there's members on the board that have been there a long, long time that maybe still have those old-fashioned views. I think from a media perspective, don't just cover female sport when they're going to a World Cup, for example, recently. I think to carry on continuing female sports, because I bet if I opened a newspaper now, there would be a tiny percentage to female sports, if any. So I think it needs to be much more consistent. But I think it is starting to change, so I think sometimes it's time.
Do you think that there is going to be a point in the future where we're going to have a female manager, for example?
Yes! In fact, I'll do it. I've got my FA Level 2 coaching qualifications. I'll manage a team, maybe in 10 years' time after I've done with broadcasting. I think we will eventually see that. But again, I think it's going to take time. I think things like... we've seen it recently with the former Chelsea doctor, Eva, and I think just making sure that we still speak out and we're show that there are strong female role models out there. You can be good at sport, you can look good at the same time, you can be intelligent as a woman. You don't have to fit in any stereotype or any mould. And yes, we will see a football manager that's female soon. I think, and I've mentioned it before, that I feel like the FA needs to change, because there's been various situations over the last 12 months that I've spoken out on where the FA seem to be, they're not proactive, and I don't think they're really reactive either a lot of the times. And I think, yeah, I do feel like that needs to change for those incidents not to happen. There needs to be a new code of conduct which everybody can follow. And I also think when it comes to the physio and the doctors, I think that there needs to be impartial doctors at football games, so that we don't have a scenario where somebody like Eva is, or you know, a doctor is scared of actually going on the pitch and actually doing their job because they're worried about getting sacked or the manager. That's a really scary scenario, because what if there was something wrong with that footballer and they made that wrong decision because they're not neutral? So I think there needs to be impartial, neutral doctors, and I think the FA need to install that. So they're the FA doctors maybe in games. That's something that they should change.
And why is it so important to celebrate particularly grassroots sport in the way we're doing tonight?
It's important to show appreciation. You know, these guys help people like me along the way when we're younger. And if it wasn't for these guys, not so many people would get that chance. You know, and that's the reason we're here, just to say thank you and show our appreciation. There's a guy called Bob Cox who was my school teacher. Sadly, he's not with us anymore, but he was a great guy for me. I had him all the way through my school years. And he was always my football coach. So, you know, that's the type of guy that, you know, that I always think of. You know, and other people like Rob Earnshaw who told me to choose football instead of cricket. And thanks for that decision, because it was the right one.
On the subject of football, obviously there's often a big debate about how well we're doing with grassroots development and bringing through particularly young English players. How do you think we are doing with that at the moment?
Well, everything's in place. You know, you can only tell by the results of what young guys come through. You know, and I think if you look at the England team, it's quite a young England team. So it's obviously working, you know, and I'm sure that the more we do it, the more players will get the opportunity to come through and shine.
I'm sure Arsenal fans want me to ask you, how do you think they're getting on this season? Obviously a fantastic result for them the other day.
Yeah, great result last night, you know, and the other result went for us as well. You know, so it puts us, you know, in a great chance. It's still in our hands, you know, but it won't be easy. But you know, it's back to the league now, and we're doing okay. We just need to get all our injuries back. Then we'll have a much better chance.
We splash some cash in the January window.
Possibly. You know, he might do, he might not do. You know, but when you look at the squad, you know, I think it does need a couple. You know, like, especially now with Cochrane going to be out for quite a while. And he's a big key player in the middle of defence for us. But he'll be missed. But like you say, if he buys a nice player in the January transfer window, I think everybody will be happy. The most important piece of advice I give to a young goalkeeper would be, believe in yourself. You will get criticised, but always believe in yourself.
I mean, nights like tonight, they're just so important to celebrate the unsung heroes in sport. And, you know, I was just saying that this is my third Pride. I've been at the Pride of Ireland, the Pride of Britain, and now the Pride of Sport. And these are areas that you just really realise that we have to compliment, and we have to really accolade people that have done, you know, incredible things over their lifetime that that put me to shame, to be honest with you. It's a really important night.
Sport played a big part in your life. Was there a sport that you were particularly into when you were at school and things like that?
Well, I mean, it's funny because people always say that I hosted a show called Total Wipeout, and that was extremely sporty, but some would argue that it was the complete opposite of that. But yeah, I'm hugely into sport, and I'm hugely into fitness and health. So for me, a night like tonight, it's just an honour to be here. Oh, lots of stuff coming up. Actually, a lot of stuff in the health and fitness arena. I've created my own sports brand. So I've got my own protein brand. I've got my own supplements. I've got my own activewear coming out. It's all sporty, actually.
If people want more information about that, where can they go?
It's not out yet, but it will be on my website come hopefully January.
Sport, for me, is something I always, you know, loved growing up. And I think it's a massively important part of growing up. And hugely important, you know, in the development of children and kind of tapping into people's talents and potential. And also, it's about bringing people together, for me, sport. And it's about being part of a team. And you learn a lot of good life skills. So, you know, it's great for me to be invited, and I'm really looking forward to seeing, you know, how the night unfolds.
Of course, you've been incredibly busy over the last few years, and the McBusted experience must have been amazing. It was great for fans. Looking back at that now, what was the highlight? What was the best part of that experience for you guys?
For me, the highlight is always touring. The start of McBusted was obviously massively exciting to see, like, how, see the reaction, you know, how excited fans were to come and see us. And but this, the shows for me, you know, we just had an amazing time and put on some crazy shows, and loved it.
Of course, I mean, you guys have got a lot going on in your own lives. You've got babies on the way and all this kind of stuff. Do you think it's going to be a while before we see you back on stage?
I don't want it to be a while until we're back on stage. You know, I want to get back doing McFly as soon as possible. So, but obviously, with a couple of McFly babies on the way, you know, that's just delaying things a little bit. So, yeah, we're really looking forward to it more than ever, because it's been a couple of years away from McFly. So, obviously, Busted are going on tour, which is very exciting. And, and obviously McBusted in the future will do some more shows, I'm sure.
I mean, you guys have achieved so much. It's staggering, really. What are you most proud of in terms of what you've already accomplished? And is there anything you've still got in your sights looking to the future?
Well, you know, for me, we're 12 years into our career, and I'd love to do this until I retire or never retire. And I think the same goes for all the other guys. So, we've done well, but I think our ambitions go way beyond what we've achieved already. So I just want to keep going and hopefully be stood here in another 12 years' time having the same conversation.
Well, there's a lot of sport where, you know, you may win or lose, and actually it's actually more important than that. It's actually there's extra motivation to keep going. I think there's difficult times at various ages as kids go through sport, whether, you know, and there are other pressures of teenage exams, whatever it is, that you need extra motivation rather than necessarily just winning or losing to carry on. Being rewarded for doing something well and as part of a team is part of it.
And of course, tonight celebrating the people who are giving us the stars of the future. I'm curious, was there one person in particular for you that had that inspiring effect?
I think as a team sport, it's more that your dreams are in someone else's hands and their dreams are in yours. So for me, it's, you know, having not done individual sport, it's the guys you're racing with. Because, you know, if you do it badly, you're going to let them down. If they do it badly, they're going to let you down. So you just get stuck in together, and, you know, special bonds are formed.
Of course, you didn't let each other down very often. I'm curious, what are you most proud of as an achievement? Which do you consider your finest moment?
I would say, so it's not actually the Olympics that I won. I went to the 1996 Olympics and I got tonsillitis on the day of the opening ceremony, so I couldn't race. And at that point, it was another 4 years until I actually could race at the Olympics again. And mates and family are saying, look, should maybe retire. But I think making a decision to carry on for another 4 years is something I'm most proud of, because I don't think I'd have won without that disappointment. And also, it's easy to make tough choices when things are going well. It's when things are going badly and you make a tough choice that, you know, you really find out what it's about.
Why is it so important to celebrate particularly grassroots level sport in this country?
Well, that's where it all starts. You have to get behind the people starting in sport. We're a very proud nation. I think the 2012 Olympic Games finally made us realise how amazing we are at sports. But a lot goes into getting those champions ready. From personal experience, you know, I started off in a little gymnastics club with a lot of volunteer coaches that didn't get paid for their time, but they gave every second of their time to helping grassroots sports and, you know, people like me. So I'm very thankful that I was given the opportunity to achieve my dream.
Of course, it's such an exciting time, particularly for British gymnastics. How excited are you looking to Rio, and what do you think the team overall can achieve this time?
It's exciting for everyone else watching and looking in. It's very nerve-wracking when you're standing in front of 10,000 people. British gymnastics are doing fantastically well at the minute, men's and women's. Winning medals, multiple medals at the World Championships, proving that we're one of the best in the world, a couple months before Rio Olympics. So, yeah, it's all happening very quickly.
What do you think has given us that watershed change? Because obviously after so many years of struggling to win medals in major championships, it seems like we can't stop now.
Well, I think every country has its day. And, you know, we see a lot of the top nations starting to have a little bit of a dip. We're having our spike. But what we haven't done very well in the past is we've been able to maintain that. So we've been doing well for quite a few number of years now. We need to try and maintain this level, keep it going, and stay being one of the best in the world. What we don't want is to have a drop off. So that's what we need to do.
I guess finally, what are your personal targets at the moment? What are you working towards specifically?
Personal targets is just to not get injured. You know, I feel very confident at the minute. My training is going fantastic well. I just want to make sure that when, you know, the time comes next year to qualify for things like the Europeans, the Olympic Games, that I'm healthy, I'm fit, because I know I stand a very good chance of making the team when that happens.
It's fantastic. Anytime people can get together and literally celebrate the great things which are happening in the UK at the moment, and we're very happy to be here, aren't we?
Absolutely. Yeah. I mean, you know, the sport takes place on so many different levels across so many different fields, and I think this tonight's a great night of celebrating that. You've got sports, you know, that aren't the most popular sports in the world. They should still be recognised, and the successes in that should still be recognised as well.
Yeah. 2016, well, we've got a few things still to come in 2015. We're in the Palladium on Sunday. We're just back from Finland. We had Dubai last week with Katy Perry. We've had a top 10 album 3 weeks ago. So we'll still all go this year. We've got closing out the Centennial Sonata celebrations at the end of the year. And then we've got our tour next year coming up. So we're doing a lot of preparation for that. And excited?
Yeah.
Well, I think fans will be more interested about the tour. For people who haven't seen you live before, what can they expect from that experience?
Well, the tour will be amazing. We've already started discussing the production of it. And one thing's for sure, you know, us four boys, we love being on the stage. Yeah. So we are going to give it our all. It'll be a fantastic show. Lots of leotards.
Pink tuxedos and all
Pink tux, yeah. Do you know Dumb and Dumber, the pale orange
maybe,
and
maybe
baby
a pony
blue
in there? You know, you never know.
It seems like such a long time that we've actually been in the studio and doing the whole process. So getting out there, meeting our supporters is a big deal for us.
Sorry.
Of course, fans love the album. Like you say, top 10 success. Is there a particular track in the album that means the most to you, though?
Oh, wow.
You wanted this. You
say, yeah, I'd probably say My Way. It means a lot to all of us, especially for me, for my my father and stuff. He passed away, and it was a song that we all sung.
We all sang at his dad's funeral earlier on in the year. So it's very special. Yeah, it means a lot.
Yeah. This is actually a song which we've just released at the moment. It's written by Randy Newman. It's called Forever. It's a really lovely song. It's about love and universal love, and it's brilliant.
Before you leave us, have you got a message for fans?
We love you all so much.
Yeah, literally, we cannot wait to come and meet you. And if you can, come and see on our tour next year. It's going to be a great night.
I've been lucky enough to be involved in the Pride of Britain for a few years on the judging panel. And the fact that the Mirror are now supporting the Pride of Sport with Sport England is hugely important. I, like tens of thousands of kids up and down the country, benefited from grassroots sport. In terms, for me, it was rugby. And people that spent their time, that volunteered their time to teach me the finer aspects of the game. I think a lot of the sort of the rules which I govern my life by, I learned from the teams that I belong to, working in a team, being a part of a team, not wanting to let people down, respect for the rules, turning up on time, delivering a great performance, all of those things, and crucially, sort of the importance that you have amongst a group and in a community. So it's fantastic that the people that volunteer their time and make a huge difference to thousands of kids up and down the country, and not just kids, get a chance to shine tonight alongside some of their heroes as well, the Alistair Cooks, the Jimmy Andersons, the Roy Hodgsons, you know, the David Hayes, the Beth Tweddles. They're all here, and we can celebrate their incredible careers along with these people that make a difference at the grassroots. Is brilliant.
What's it like being part of the same team as Piers Morgan?
Well, he's brought a new dynamic to the team. That's unquestionable. You know, it's. I think I spoke to Susanna yesterday, and she said she described him as a mini tornado, and she may have to upgrade that storm warning. So yeah, it's been an important part of being any team is the dynamic, and Piers has brought a whole new dynamic. Great eye for a story and has incredible history in terms of interviewing people, both on screen and on in print as well. So as a, in terms of sort of what we do, that's a hugely important that's a hugely important facet to your style. I think if you ask Pierce himself, what you see is what you get. I mean, he is who he is, and that's what makes him unique, and that's what makes him who he is, and that's, you know, the success that he's achieved, wherever it is, has come about because, you know, there is no difference to Pierce on screen and Pierce off screen.
Well, I'm, you know, one of the roles of the FA, obviously, is the grassroots, and it's to build grassroots sports and to support, really applaud the people who pioneer it, who run it, because they're often the unsung heroes of sport, the people who run the local football club and who bring through the kids. Well, we will decide who's to support for the presidency of FIFA in the new year. And as I understand it, Mr. Platini is going to appeal whatever decision is made. Whether it all works out in time for him to stand, I don't know. But we won't decide who we're supporting until the new year. Well, of course, what Mr. Blatter's salary is has never been published. And, of course, it should have been. Should have been over many years. I have no idea what he's earned. I just hope he's not coming back. Well, I see that he met some angels. A bit surprising, I think. It does seem... he's becoming more eccentric as he gets older, let's put it politely. He has presided over a corrupted organisation, and it's been known for years it's corrupted. Therefore, it's very hard to see, to describe him as honest. We've known that FIFA is a corrupted organisation for many years. What we need is a fundamental change within FIFA. Now, we might, and that's just not about changing the president, that's about changing the way FIFA is run and organised. And some progress is being made, but there's a lot more to be done.
You know, I think people do sport and are athletes because they love the adrenaline, they love the way they make you feel. You get in the zone, you get in that pocket, and I think it's just a good time to be like, hey man, you're going out there, you're kicking butt, you're a badass, and a kind of, you know, giving some attention and some praise for it.
Particularly for young people, much like with dancing, there's a lot of discipline, a lot of life lessons they can learn from it.
100%. I mean, for me, dance was everything. It was my escape, it was my teacher, it was my discipline. And, you know, if I didn't have that, I could have gotten into trouble. I could have gone another direction. But I was so into it, and I loved it so much. I loved the sport. I loved the art of it. And so I think that there's something that gives you a sense of self-confidence. I think that's great for your body. It keeps you healthy. And you know, it's amazing to me that kids growing up now, because you look back at the stuff I was doing and it looks like mediocre now to what kids are doing. And that's what's so cool is that as humans, we just keep evolving into like these little ninjas. So it's pretty cool.
What are you evolving into in 2016? What have you got on your plate next year?
Woo, honey. 2016, I'm doing a show over in the States called First Look for NBC. So that's been keeping me busy. I've been shooting that. I've also been shooting with Keith Lemon, doing his comedy sketch show. We've been, he's got me doing some really funny characters over the series, so I'm really stoked about that and excited to be part of that. And then just a few little like projects I got going on. So 2016, I think, is going to be good.
Can you tell us any more about that NBC series?
NBC series, it's called First Look, and it's a lifestyle, adventure, fine dining, and it's my own little show where I get to kind of show the world through my perspective really awesome things to do and in areas maybe you didn't know of, and just to kind of like go on a little life adventure, which is awesome.
Of course, it's always an adventure working with Keith. Of those characters that you're playing, are there any that will recognize, any famous faces he's got you dressing up?
He might have got me to play Caitlyn Jenner. That might have happened, but we did it in a very, very fun way. I mean, I'm all about the gay community, the transgender community, I'm all about Caitlyn. Go Caitlyn. But we had a little bit of fun with it, so it was a good time.
Have you got a message to fans out there who absolutely love you?
Oh, gosh. Yeah, to fans out there that love me, man, I love you. Thank you so much. I get to do so many awesome, cool things because I still have your support, so namaste.